Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about government schemes quiz for day 9. We've already covered last 8 days and they have been very successful. Students are liking it. They are being helped by it. So if you have not started with these quizzes, start with them immediately. Let me give you an introduction to you and tell you exactly how can you take the quiz yourself as well, and how can you take this quiz with me through this video. As you can see on the screen, there is the website wherein there is a quiz section at the top where you can go to RBI Grade B section. If you want to take daily quizzes, you can go to daily current affairs section as well. But for now, let's go to RBI Grade B section. As you go to RBI Grade B section, you see all these daily quizzes being uploaded here. So on the first 3 days, we started with controlling for management, which is a very important area. Then we did some quizzes on government schemes. On day 7, we did a series on organization theory, which I'm going to continue in the future as well. Yesterday, we had day 8 quiz, and today we are going to cover day 9 quiz. Okay, let's start with day 9 quiz. You can take these quizzes by yourself as well. You don't need to sit with me in order to take the quiz, but all these quizzes that I'm posting here can be taken by you as well independently, and I'm going to discuss all these questions simultaneously so that you're able to understand what are the mistakes you're making, and we are able to discuss things together. So it's given a lot of time, so you can use that time and take the quiz at ease, because the objective is to be accurate rather than try and cover it faster. Let's have a look at the first question. The question says that to get the benefit of Sebha Bhoj scheme, the eligible institutions will be required to first register with the portal of Niti Aayog. What is the name of that portal? We talked about Sebha Bhoj scheme yesterday also in day 8 quiz. If you have not taken that quiz and the previous quizzes, please go and take those quizzes before starting with this quiz, because they will create that platform for you so that you are able to move along with us. Okay, be sure to take those quizzes also simultaneously, or after this quiz also you can go and take that quiz. Okay, we talked about Sebha Bhoj scheme. What is the answer of this question? The answer is B, Darpan portal. As I had explained yesterday in day 8 quiz, Sebha Bhoj is for GST waiver for religious institutions which are providing food to a certain number of people per month. What is that number? Tell that number to me in the comment section below. The number is 5,000 people per month. 5,000 people per month for the last 3 years. Okay. All the charitable institutions, whether they are Hindu, whether they are Muslim, whether they are church or Christian, whether they are Sikh, all the kinds of charitable institutions are included in this. Which ministry carries out or is carrying out this particular scheme? Please provide that answer to me in the comment section below. Although it's available here as well, I'm going to hide it. Okay, let's come to the second question now very quickly. The question says, under the line Housing for All by 2022 and to boost demand and supply of low-cost homes, Affordable Housing Fund has been created. You must be aware about that. Consider the statements and pick out the correct option about Affordable Housing Fund and Housing for All. Announced under National Housing Bank, number 1. Created for 60,000 crore, number 2. Announced in February 2019, number 3. Ministry of Urban Development has created this fund, number 4. And this fund is situated in BMTPC. Please provide me the full form of BMTPC also in the comment section below. I will be discussing it very shortly. The correct answer is C, 1, 2 and 5. 3 is wrong because it was launched in February 2018 and it is not under Ministry of Urban Development. Ministry of Urban Development has been subsumed under another ministry. Name that ministry for me. I will be discussing it shortly also. As I said, announced in Feb 2018, implemented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, Ministry of Urban Development has been subsumed under Ministry of Housing. A new name has been created, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Target is Housing for All by 2022. You must be aware about that. National Housing Bank will be promoting it. 60,000 crore is the fund, and BMTPC full form is Building Materials and Technology Promotion Council, which is going to be working on it. Okay. Let's come to the third question for today. The question says, based on the success of the pilot project of Solar Charkha Mission, the Indian government launched this scheme in June 2018 all over India. When and where was the pilot project implemented? See, all these pilot projects, which are basically first projects, or the areas or state or districts where it is implemented first implementation or launch district or state, all these are important. They have been asked regularly in the exam, therefore I'm covering it. The answer to this question is Bihar in the year 2016. Solar Charkha pilot project was implemented in Khanwa village in Nawada district of Bihar in 2016, and Khadi, the ministry which is responsible for this is Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, okay, which launched Solar Charkha Mission. The purpose of this mission is to create clusters in order to provide training and loan to rural people in order to learn the art of looms and spindles and start creating their own organizations, their own small setups in order to promote Solar Charkha based or handloom based industries in India. The fourth question is, National Nutrition Mission, Poshan Abhiyan. Please provide me with the full form of Poshan Abhiyan. I will be discussing it very shortly also, but it's very important that you remember and recall it right now and write it right now in the comment section below. NNM, Poshan Abhiyan, was launched in the year 2018 with some targets. One of its targets is to reduce stunting in children. What is the target percentage of reduction? The answer is by 6% at the rate of 2% per annum. POSHAM stands for Prime Minister's Overarching Scheme for Holistic Nutrition, approved in the year 2017 and renamed POSHAN in 2018, implemented by which ministry? Ministry of Women and Child Development. Ministry of Women and Child Development, and the budget is for 3 years. Let's come to the last question for today. POSHAN again was launched by Ministry of Women and Child Development, as I just said. Who among the following is not covered under this scheme? Lactating mothers, pregnant women, children between 0 to 6 years, or children between 7 to 14 years. I think the answer should be D, children between 7 to 14 years, and that is the correct answer. A ministry of this Poshan Abhiyan was launched in Rajasthan in 2018. So this is something very important that you need to remember. Okay, it covers all children between 0 to 6, and adolescent girls are covered, not boys. Okay. So this was the quiz for day 9. I hope I've covered a lot of schemes through this particular quiz. Tomorrow we shall be holding the quiz for day 10. So stay tuned. All the very best. Take care and keep taking these quizzes by logging into the website as well. If you like this lesson, if you learn something new, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. All the very best again. Take care.